Hello people, welcome back to my channel. So today in this video, let's see a type of classifier called as rule-based classifier. So as the name suggests, it's a classifier which has certain rules by which it classifies its record. So let's begin. So it's basically a technique for collecting records using a bunch of if-else rules. So these rules are essentially in disjunctive normal form, means they are connected with logical or operators. So you have in programming, that is, if this condition is true, then this rule will trigger. So certain conditions are there in this. So just consider this R is equal to, you have rule 1 or rule 2 or say rule K. So this is basically how it looks. So this, what you can see, is called as a rule set. And these things are called as disjuncts or classification rules. And so these are certain examples of some of the rules which are there in the rule-based classifier. So you have rule 1. So it takes the form in parentheses. So it has attribute value pairs and similarly connected with another rule, and this derives some particular rule. So now this takes the form, that is RI, you write a colon, and then you have some condition of I. There can be n number of conditions which derives some rule, say YI. Now this, what you can see on the left hand side, is called as rule antecedent, or you called as a precondition. And this part, so this takes the form AJ OP VJ. So this is attribute value pair. Now this OP represents some operator. So it can be like less than or less than equal to, or it can be greater than equal to, or it can be equal to or not equal to. So these things are basically called as conjuncts, since it connects different types of attribute value pairs constituting a rule. And this is called as a rule consequent. Okay, so we have seen the structure or the syntax, how different rules are there in rule-based classifiers. Now, in order to evaluate the quality of each of the rule, there are two measures basically in rule-based classifiers. So first, what you have called as the coverage. So coverage of a particular rule is given by fraction of records in your data set D, which triggers your rule R. So whichever your rule is there, that is small r, so the fraction of records from the data set which are triggered by rule R, basically the coverage. So mathematically it is represented by divided by this. So this is, that is the rule antecedent, and divided by the number of records which are there in the data set. So this represents the magnitude. And second measure is you have the accuracy. So accuracy is also called as confidence factor. So accuracy of a rule is given by fraction of records in data set D, which is triggered by rule R, which has same class label as Y. So this is given as A divided by this term. So this has got both antecedent as well as consequent, and divided by, you have the antecedent. So here the two denominators are different. Here you have the total number of data set or records, and here you have the antecedent. Now let's consider the example of how this basically works, or how it basically classifies its record. So say for example, you have given a data set of vertebrata, and you have these many attributes, and you have these records. So what you have to do is basically you have to classify each of this record into these many rules. So these are basically our classes. So what you can see, these are basically classes and we have certain rules. So based upon this, we'll classify this. So first, that is, you have for lemur, you have the body temperature and warm. So, and you have, that is, aquatic creature, no, and gives birth, yes. So right now we have considered only two attributes, that is gives birth as well as you have the aquatic creature. So gives birth, yes, and body temperature is equal to warm blooded. We'll classify this as mammal. So this has basically rule 3. So it's classified with the help of rule 3 and it comes under mammals. This is clear. Now then you have the second record. So we need to classify this. So it's turtle and body temperature is cold blooded. So nowhere we can see cold blooded, but we can have aquatic creature, that is semi. So aquatic creature is there, that is you have gives birth, no, and aerial creature is equal to no. So that is this one, and gives birth, that is no. So we can say that it is triggered by, that is rule 4. But if you see, that is for aquatic creature, that is semi, it also satisfies this rule. So it has both rule 5 as well as rule 4. So it can belong to either mammals or reptiles. So this is one problem with this rule based classifier, means for a particular record it can belong to two classes or two rules are triggered for this. And now let's consider the third record, that is dogfish stark. So you have cold blooded as the body temperature, but nowhere you can see cold blooded body temperature, and other features, you don't have any other features. So what happens is, to which class does this record belongs to? So that is the major question in this. So in order to overcome this problem, it has got two rules or properties basically. So first rule is, you have mutually exclusive rules. So what it says is that for one particular record, it should not have two rules or not more than one rule. Like here what we have seen, that for one particular record we had two rules, so this should not be the case. And second is that exhaustive rules. So for each particular record it should trigger only one rule, so that should satisfy throughout the data set. Next, what we have two types of rules in this. So rules in rule based classifier are of two types. First we have ordered rules and then we have unordered rules. So ordered rules are also called as decision list, and what it does is basically it categorizes into the decreasing priority, means whichever has the lowest priority that goes up and whichever has the highest priority goes down. So this is majorly done with the help of, you have maximum description length, or you can combine with accuracy, that is one quality measure for one particular rule, or you can have coverage. So with this you create ordered rules. Next, what you have is, you have unordered rules. So you have certain advantages over ordered rules. Why? Because this will take majority voting from a set of rules for a particular record. Say here in this example we have one record that belongs to two classes. Now what this unordered rules will do is, it will see whether all other classes or all other records belongs to how many rules. So based upon that, it will classify into one of the rules or into one of these classes. So that is the main advantage of unordered rules over the ordered rules. And then what you have is, you have the error rate. So error rate as compared to ordered rules in classifying the records is usually low in this. So that means that in unordered rules you can easily classify the records in a better efficient way. So well, that was all regarding the rule based classifier in machine learning. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you found got educated watching this video, please do like, share, comment, and if you are new to the channel, please consider subscribing. Thank you very much for watching this video.